Haha, what's going on, people? BPhife here, back at you. Rainbow Six Siege PlayStation 4. This is a reboot of my last video. I had to take it down just because of the quality and the mic game, everything. Some of the things I said, it just didn't work. So I'm redoing this. So if you've already seen that video, I apologize, but it might be worth your time to listen to this one. Because, you know, I'm not going to say everything exactly the same way. Information's pretty much the same. But, you know, I'm just going to deliver it a little differently. As you can see, I'm joining a losing match. Normally, I would already back out at this time. But for some reason, I just wanted to take on this challenge of trying to make it happen, you know. And you definitely will see, you know, what I do. I just wanted to see if I would be I could be the difference maker. That's really what it came down to. I just wanted to see what kind of skills can I bring a Bootsy team back on, you know, carry the team and bring them. You know, are they the Milwaukee Bucks and can I take them to a championship? You know what I mean? But anyway, I just want to shout out to everyone that's made my last video a complete success. You know, the Skyscraper video, that's one of the things I want to talk about in this video. And also I want to shout out to, you know, a lot of the big influx of new subscribers, man. You know, thanks for coming through. You know, I want to make these videos so you guys can enjoy them. I'm not making them to try to frustrate you. I'm just making them, you know, because I'm enjoying them. I would like to share them with you. And, you know, just keep, you know, watching. I'm going to try to make them on a more regular basis. I might pick some days where you can count on some uploads, you know, so we'll do it like that. But right now I'm just trying to put in that work right now on the Rainbow Six Siege. This has been a game that I have just been on since day one. Got it on both consoles. And you know, that's an Xbox One is where I actually saw the Skyscraper asset, you know, where it's just strictly the Skyscraper asset. Look at that, dudes is already down, man. You know I got my work cut out for me, but hey, I'm ready to put in that work. But anyway, let's get right to it. So Rainbow Six Siege, you know, so I made that video. If you haven't seen it, I made a video talking about the possibilities of a Skyscraper map coming to as DLC content. And actually, one of the developer diaries, they were talking about how, you know, that's something that they want to do and they're toying with the idea. And, you know, I personally believe that they've already done it and they're just, you know, putting it out there, because developers don't typically put things out there unless they can deliver, because they don't want to put themselves in a position to get ridiculed, you know, especially in today's day and age with social media and all this other stuff. You know, people don't really want to put themselves in a bad light, you know. You know, nobody's gonna post a picture of them, you know, taking candy from a baby or doing something that they shouldn't be doing. People always want to, you know, put themselves in a good light. So I don't think that developers want to say things outlandish and not be able to deliver, or, you know, just say stuff and have us getting used to them saying outlandish stuff. But this video right here, I don't know if you've already saw, but that you could see the consulate. You could see the Skyscraper in the back of the consulate map, like right there. And here's the thing, you know, a couple people put a message in there stating that, you know, oh, well, you know, it's just part of the backdrop. It was, you know, this and that, blah, blah, blah. But my thing is this, if you're on this map, why not show this? Why not show the consulate in there? You know what I mean? I think what happens is they have a bunch of assets in the game, because when they were trying to do the campaign, you know, before they were, because they were originally going to do a campaign, and they left a lot of that stuff in there, and they said, hey, you know, maybe we'll unlock it as DLC. That's just my speculation. So there's a lot of content that we're not seeing, and I think I just happened to access some of this content, and you know, that's why I made that video, because, you know, I accessed something that people don't see. And to me, I think it's foreshadowing for what is to come in DLC, because, you know, they probably have this already done, you know, and they probably made that asset strictly just to, you know, just showcase the, you know, the Skyscraper map. Okay, it could be a speculation, maybe not, maybe, you know, but either way, this is how I'm feeling about it. And, you know, I just want to share that with you guys, especially since I'm the only one that I know right now that has been privy to see that shot, because if it is a glitch, you're not supposed to see it, you know what I mean? So you know, the cat could be out the bag, you know, with that video. But you know, another thing I'm thinking about with that map was, I would love to see just maybe, you know, maybe like 4 or 5 levels. You know, you don't have to do all 90 or whatever the case, you know, skyscraper might be, you know, however tall it might be. You don't have to make that many levels or whatever. Look, difference maker one. See, I'm already making a difference with this game, with these guys taking the Milwaukee Bucks again and trying to take them to the playoffs at least, you know what I mean? Maybe even all the way. We'll see. Keep watching the video, we'll take a look at that. But yeah, for the skyscraper map, oh, I also will have some opinions on operators, and I have some ideas for some operators, so stay tuned for. Alright, and to all my NBA 2K subscribers or any type of sports simulation subscribers, I'm definitely going to be making a lot of videos with a lot of fresh new content. You know, not going to rehash old legacy bugs and issues, you know, things that the developers already know, but it's just for some reason they can't fix them. You know, I'm seeing a lot of guys out here doing a lot of complaining, and then when they find out what the reason why they can't be fixed, you know, they're kind of like dumbfounded a little bit. You know, hey, I don't blame them, you know, they just don't know, you know what I mean? There are reasons why certain things happen. That's why you have to be able to articulate and bring out new things that are having you know, other issues and stuff like that. So definitely want to bring that to the table. You know, like with the Czar, I put a comment on one of his videos and whatnot, and he really liked the idea. Months later, he commented and said, hey, you know, it's not my department, but I think this is something that, you know, we should do, paraphrasing what he's saying. So, you know, I want to make a video elaborating on that, you know what I mean? Because, you know, legacy bugs and issues, yes, they are a problem, but you know what, to be honest with you, there's a lot of things that you as the user can do to not allow yourself to see these things. You know, you could play basketball, you could you know, do a lot of things, use a lot of the tools that are there. You know, that's one of my things, BPhife's big three. You know, use the tools that are there for you. You know, the game has a vision, you know, utilize that vision, you know, and the execution, there are problems, there are issues with the game. You know, I believe, shout out to my man Books, you know, I kind of align myself with the way he thinks. He can appreciate both sides, you know, people that are upset and people that are frustrated, as well as the people that are unaware of what's going on and why things still occur, you know. And I have the pleasure to be able to know a lot on both sides, so that's why I kind of tend to align myself with Books, just kind of the mentality of, you know, doing things. And on one of the podcasts that he was on, you know, somebody had a real big frustration. Then they found out, firsthand that, you know, what they were seeing is just a result of evolving technology. You know what I'm saying? It's like a lot of the frustrations can be answered if, you know, if the developers, you know, one, are being forthcoming. You know, that, I mean, because a lot of this frustrations is festered between silence on the, look at these kills, man. I love these kills. You know, a lot of these frustrations are being festered due to silence on the developer side. They could ease a lot of this social media pain if they just came out and just said, hey, boom, we see this legacy issue. We see that we can't fix it because of this, or we can, or we're trying, or whatever, you know, the case may be. Now, it gets to the point where some of you guys don't take that for an answer. That's when it's on back on you. It's back on you when you can't take those for an answer. Okay. There are different, you know, expectations on both sides. And I'm going to make videos on that. What point as a consumer do you wait for a developer? And at what point as a consumer do you say, oh, you're just stalling? You know what I'm saying? That's one of my videos coming up. I'm gonna make a video on it. Definitely, you know, check that out. Another video is, you know, I just I mean, this is kind of a touchy little subject, but, you know, I just don't like the way people are delivering information these days. I just personally have a problem with it. I feel like, you know, a lot of the stuff that's coming up, you know, that has come up in these talks and in these videos and these podcasts and these hangouts and stuff like that have been a result of somebody's efforts before them. Like, for example, you know, the sim community that I was a part of, the YouTube sim community, a lot of the members have disbanded, but you know how much content we've created, and you know how many people right now that are still relevant, you know, are saying the same things, rehash, bringing it up, but looking like they're the ones that came up with the, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of treasure in King Tut's tomb that's not there anymore. And the people that are taking it and cashing in, they weren't the ones that put it there. You know what I mean? So, you know, I'm just going to make it. Hey, it is what it is. Difference maker two. Here we go. By the way, difference maker two. But you know what I'm saying? There's a lot of things that people, you know, like there's forgotten history books on how things really go down. So anyway, it's, you know, just a lot of things going on. But anyway, finish watching the video. This is the last round. Go ahead and check it out. Again, thanks for the support. More videos coming. You may or may not like them, you know, depending on, you know, how you take these videos. But hey, I'm just saying what I have to say. It's your boy, BPhife. I'm enjoying, you know, what I'm seeing so far. I'll let you guys later.